Hi children, in the last video we have seen about the electronic configuration of 3D block elements. Okay, now we will see about the electronic configuration of the 4D block elements in this video. Okay, how that electronic configuration can be written easily. Okay, that we will see in this video. First of all, we will write down the general formula. It goes with NS 0 to 2. N minus 1 D 1 to 10. Okay, now we write down the names of the elements of the 4D block. Okay, the 4D block elements goes with yttrium. Please note down the symbols also while you are writing. Yttrium, zirconium, niobium. Okay, niobium. Next, molybdenum, technetium, okay, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver, then cadmium. Okay, now we will just write down its electronic configuration. We know, as we have learnt for our 3D block, we know the whichever the nearest to octet configuration for these elements, for these metals, are actually goes with the krypton, because argon after is krypton only. You know that the names of the elements in the 18th group: helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, right? So the krypton will go for this 4D block elements, because the 5S starts from next element, or next, what is that, calcium. Next calcium after we have that strontium, isn't it? So strontium next is goes with the yttrium. Now we'll write down its atomic number. The atomic number is actually 30 is got over for zinc in the last 3D. Now it is not going to be 30, because we have that other 6 elements of P block and 2 more elements of the S block, isn't it? So adding of those two, it starts with the 39. Okay, 39 40, then it comes the consecutive numbers only you need, right? 42 43 44 45 46 47 48. So it goes up to 48. Now, as we have learnt for our 3D block elements, here also you just write down the 1 to 10 elements. 1 to 10, that is 1 to 10 elements are going to be seen. We are going to see from yttrium to cadmium. So we are going to fill in how many electrons are going to be there for each one of them, each one of the 4D block. So we have 4D subshell. So we are going to write down 10 elements name. That is, instead of writing names, you write it down as numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. As we have written for the last 3D, again you fill it up for 5 and 10 as half filled and fulfilled. So let it be as it is, 5 and 10 itself. So no change in that. Here for 4D, omit numbers 3, 6, 9, where we have omitted 4 and 9. Here you have to omit 3, 6, 9. So omit 3rd number, 6th number and 9th number. So what happened naturally? What are the numbers to be written down? Let us write down 1, 2, since there is no 3, so write as 4. Then 4 after, it's going to be 5 only, again 5. No 6, so write as 7. Then 8 it is here. Then 8 once written, but no 9, so write it as 10 here. Here also 10, because 10 only number of electrons, so you have to write again 10 only. Now what you do, we know the configuration of, what is the next configuration? As we have now said, it is only krypton. So write down that krypton over here. Okay, krypton for everyone. for all the elements, write down that Krypton configuration. As we know that Krypton configuration, it takes, so we are not writing that Krypton all the configuration, it would go very long. So for that we are making it short, that's all. So taking down that Krypton configuration over here. Okay. Since we know that Krypton configuration is a stable configuration, we know the number of electrons in that also. Actually, the number of electrons for Krypton is, argon it is 18, you just add another 18 electrons over here. Okay, another 18 number. Why? Because we know the first period has two elements, second period has 8 elements, next 8 elements, then next 18, that is fourth one is 18, fifth one is also 18, then 32, 32. We know that order. So according to that, you can add up that number of electrons to the to the octet configuration, that is to your noble gas. Now we write down that 4D, right? 4D subshell. So let me write down that 4D subshell over there. So everywhere I just write down that 4D. As I told you, we write first 4D only, since the 4D got started filling down. So we are writing down 4D first, then only 5S, because this is 4D and 5S configuration. The outermost shell is 4D, 5S configuration. So I write on that 5S over here. Next one also for all the elements. Okay. So it is written for everything, for all the elements. Now we start filling down the number of electrons for 3D shell first, because we have already come to know what are the electrons going to be there for the first 10, the 10 elements from yttrium to cadmium. So the number 1 will go for 1, that is first element is this. So first element of that 4D series is yttrium, so 1, then 2, okay, there is no 3, so write 4, then 5, again 5. Then this is actually going with the ruthenium. I said there is no 6, no, so write 7, 8, 10. I am writing down the numbers which are written over here only. Okay. So I am just taking it over here. That's all. 10, 10. Now what I have told you, as I told you already, argon is 18. Add up another 18 for Krypton. 18 plus 18, 36. Totally number of electrons in Krypton is 36. So add up 36 plus 1, 37. Then just subtract it from 39. That would be the number of electrons for 5S. Okay. So it would be easy. You just add Krypton and the number of electron in D cell. Totally it is 36 plus 1, 37. 39 is there. 36 minus of 37, it is going to be 2. So you are now writing down the NS orbital, that is 5S orbitals number of electrons. 4D we finished by doing this way. Now this is 36. I write again so that it would be easy for you. 36 plus 2, 38. Again 40, it's 2 only. Then this is 36 plus 4, actually 40. 41 minus of 40, it's going to be 1. Okay. 42, Krypton 36. You can also do it on your own, children. You just keep writing down. While I'm writing also, you also note down so that it would be easy. Then 36 plus 5, it is 41. 42 minus, again, 41, it is 1 only. Okay. Isn't it? Molybdenum, 41. 45, 5S, 1. Then technetium, 43. Krypton, 36. 36 plus 5, 41. 43 minus of 41, it is 2. Then here, for this one, that is ruthenium, 36 plus 7, 43. 44 minus 43 is going to be 1 only. Okay. Now, this take down this rhodium, 36. 36 plus 8, it is 44. 45 minus of 44 is going to be 1 only. Krypton, then this is palladium, 36. 36 plus 10, 46. 46 again palladium. 46 minus of 46, 0. So, we are getting 1, 0 also for some of the S shells. So, that's the reason we are writing NS 0 to, we are writing that is 0 to 2, NS 0 to 2. Okay, it may come 0 or 1 or 2. Right? Now, the next one, silver, 47. This is 36 minus 10, it is 46. 47 minus of 46 is 1. Okay. Last one, 48, 36 here. 36 plus 10, 46, 46, 48 minus 46. It's going to be 2. Hope you have understood this, right? This is the way you can write down for 4D series also. Isn't it? So the numbers to be for to be omitted, 3, 6, 9. So cut off that 3, 6, 9 and write down the numbers like this. Okay. Don't write, rewrite that number again. Whatever the number you have finished, don't write it again. 4 once over, go with the next number. Since it is already filled in, we are having the same numbers. There are two times of 5. Don't worry about it. But here also, you are writing 8 to 10 only. 9 again, 10 only. Because we need to write 10 only. Since there are only 10 electrons can be filled in DHL. Okay, this is the way you have to write. Hope you have understood this 4D series also. Let us go with the 5D series in the next video. Thank you.